The game view shows a representation of our final published game. In the game view, we can play and test our game in its current state at any time. The play mode buttons in the toolbar allow us to play, pause, and step through our game on a frame-by-frame basis. To enter play mode, simply click on the play button. When our game is running, we can choose to pause the game by clicking on the pause button, or step frame by frame through our game. At the top of the game view is the game view control bar. The game view control bar contains items that allow us to customize how the game view is displaying our game. The first item to the left in the game view control bar is the display drop-down menu. The display drop-down menu allows us to choose between a list of cameras in the scene. It is set to display 1 by default, and we can assign the display a camera is rendering to by changing the target display property of any camera. Displays also allow us to isolate specific cameras during playtesting. Displays can also be used with the multi-display feature. The multi-display feature allows us to display up to 8 different camera views from our game on up to 8 different monitors at the same time. For more information on multi-display, please see the information linked below. The next item in the game view control bar is the aspect drop-down menu. The aspect drop-down menu allows us to select different values to test how our game will look on monitors with different aspect ratios and resolutions. By testing with different resolutions and aspect ratios, we can ensure that all of the layouts, cameras, and items within our game, such as our UI elements, are working correctly for all of our target platforms. We can also add a custom resolution or aspect ratio to this list. To add our own custom resolution or aspect ratio, we can simply click on the plus button, name the custom setting, and add the values for either a fixed resolution or aspect ratio. To the right of the drop-down menu is the scale slider. The scale slider allows us to zoom in and examine areas of the game view in more detail. We can also zoom out to see the entire screen in situations where the target resolution is higher than the game view window size. It's also worth noting that when the game is not running or paused, we can use the scroll wheel to zoom in and out. We can also use the middle mouse button to move around the game view window while zoomed in. On the right-hand side of the game view control bar are the Maximise on play and mute audio buttons, and the stats and gizmos drop-down menus. The Maximise on play button allows us to toggle a full-screen preview of our game. When Maximise on play is not selected, our game will play within the current game view. When the Maximise on play button is selected and play mode is entered, the game view will maximise in the editor, filling as much of the screen as possible. Note that even when maximised, the game view will maintain our chosen resolution or aspect ratio. The mute audio button, when selected, will mute any in-game audio in play mode. The stats button toggles a statistics overlay containing rendering statistics about our game's audio and graphics. This is useful for monitoring the performance of our game while in play mode. The final button in the game view control bar is the gizmo toggle. The gizmo toggle enables and disables the visibility of gizmos in the game view. Similar to the scene view, from the gizmo menu, we can select which gizmos we'd like to see in the game view. For more information on gizmos and the gizmos menu, see the information linked below. While the game is running and the editor is in play mode, we can make changes to our game objects in the scene. For instance, we can move and edit the transform of game objects in our scene, or adjust values and properties of components in the inspector. This allows us to see how any potential changes will affect our game. It is worth noting, however, that any of the changes we make in the editor while it is in play mode will be reset when we exit play mode. Any changes to physical assets, such as materials, will not be reset and these changes will persist, as they are not in the current scene. The editor UI darkens when we are in play mode. This reminds us that the changes we are making will be reset when we exit play mode. We can customize this change in color by adjusting the play mode tint setting in Preferences. To do this, we choose Edit, Preferences, Colors, and select our desired color for the play mode tint under the general heading. As we can see, the game view is ideal for previewing our game without having to leave the Unity editor.